When he was speaking, Pastor Moses Mondo, when he was speaking,
wakati,
like 2 weeks ago, I think,
Pastor Mondo akihubiri wiki mbili iliyopita,
he said that this is our church.
Akasema hii ni kanisa letu.
This is not my church.
Na hii sio kanisa langu.
But it is our church.
Amen.
Lakini ni kanisa letu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But sometimes we say, oh, I'm going to the church of somebody.
Sawa, wakati mwingine unasema naenda kanisa la mtu fulani.
But truly it's not a church belong to somebody.
Lakini ukweli kanisa liko mtu.
But the church belong to God.
Lakini kanisa ni ya Mungu.
Because he's the one, the church has been founded by him.
Kwa sababu hiyo kanisa inapatikana kwake.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the church belong to Jesus Christ.
Kwa hivyo kanisa ni Yesu Kristo.
The church belong to God.
Na kanisa ni ya Mungu.
Who intended to initiate or to start the church.
Na yeye ndiye alimwanzilisha kanisa.
It means we are all co-workers.
Kwa hivyo sisi watumishi
in the kingdom of God.
Katika utukufu, katika ufalme wa Mungu.
So the pastor wanted to say,
kwa hivyo mtu pastor alisema,
that each and everybody,
kila mmoja wetu,
he needs to bring,
lazima alete,
his stone,
jiwe lake.
Somebody else can bring the bricks.
Mkuu anaweza kuleta matofali.
Other people can bring, I don't know wood.
Mwingine anaweza kuleta sijui kani jiwe.
So that we can build,
ama mti,
we can build the kingdom of God.
Ili tupate kujenga ufalme wa Mungu.
Hallelujah.
That's why today, ndio maana kwa leo,
we are saying that our title today,
ndio maana somo letu leo,
is that to serve the Lord.
Tumikia Mungu.
Hallelujah.
To serve the Lord.
Tumikia Bwana.
All of us, we are called to serve the Lord. Sisi wote tumeitwa kumtumikia Mungu.
So this service is not for a certain person.
Kwa hivyo kumtumikia Mungu sio kwa watu fulani.
But this service, the service in the kingdom, is for each and everybody.
Kwa hivyo kumtumikia Mungu katika ufalme wa Mungu ni
that the Lord has called.
Ndio Mungu aliita.
By his name.
Jina lake,
so that he can be in his glory, he can be in his kingdom.
Ili upate katika utukufu wake katika ufalme wake.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
To serve the Lord.
Tumikia Bwana.
And we're going to read the book of Romans.
Nasoma katika kitabu cha Warumi.
Chapter 12.
Mlango wa 12.
Verse 1.
Verse 1.
Charles will read for us in Swahili.
Charles atasoma kwa Kiswahili.
And the destiny you can read for us in the English version.
Na destiny tutasomea katika versio ya Kiingereza.
Romans 12 verse 1.
Roman 12 verse 1. Romain 12 verse 1.
Somebody, if you are ready in Swahili, you can read for us.
Kwa hiyo ndugu zangu, hata Mungu ni mwenye huruma. Awasi wa moyo wote. Toleeni nafsi zenu kwa Mungu kama dhabihu iliyo hai, takatifu na yenye kupendeza. Hii ndiyo njia yenu halisi ya kumwabudu.
Amen. Thank you very much. Destiny, can you read for us also in English in Romans chapter 12 verse 1?
I'll read in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
So Romans 12 verse 1 says, my Christian friend, God has been very kind to us. Because of that, I really want you to serve God with your whole life. Offer your bodies to him like a sacrifice that continues to live. Serve him with everything that you have, and that will please him. That is the true way to worship God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This, he, scripture we are reading from Romans,
ambayo maandiko tusoma katika Warumi,
which really was written by Paul,
ambayo imeandikwa na mtumishi wa Mungu Paul.
Therefore I urge you brothers and sisters,
ndio maana anasema wapendwa katika Kristo,
in God's mercy,
katika upendo wa Mungu, kama neema ya
Paul, he's asking us,
Paul anatuomba,
he's asking brothers and sisters,
anasema kaka na dada,
he's urging us,
anatuomba,
to offer our bodies as living sacrifice.
Sisi tutoe mwili wetu kama sadaka takatifu.
And when he's saying it is,
na wakati anaposema hivyo,
he's not only speaking to brothers only,
hasemi tu kwa kaka,
but he's talking about to sisters,
na kwa wadada pia.
Hallelujah. Amen. So can see that here we have two genders.
Tunaona hapa tuko na aina mbili.
So we have male and we have female.
Tuko na wamama na wababa.
Brothers, it means are men.
Tukisema wakaka ni wanaume.
And sisters, it means are women.
Tukisema wadada ni wanawake.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It means the service of the Lord.
Kwa hivyo kutumikia Mungu,
it's for you and I.
without no exception. It means men are called, and women also are called to serve the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are some areas, some places we went, but there are some restrictions saying that a woman cannot preach. But we see here that the Bible is saying, the Bible is calling both of them, women and male, that they are there to give themselves as living sacrifice. Hallelujah. It means both of them, they can serve the Lord in different ways. Paul is saying, I argue, brothers and sisters, to offer your bodies, to give your effort, to give everything you have, to sacrifice yourself, to suffer yourself for the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. There's nothing great, there's nothing good, special here on earth like serving the Lord. Hallelujah. To serve the Lord, you don't need to be hired. Hallelujah. You need only to be called by the Master. And when you are called, you are qualified. Hallelujah. That's the only CV you need to present before the Lord. You are called and you accept the calling and then you enter in the service. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So nobody will ask you many, many things. You went to which university? You went to which school? You are from which origin? You are from which country? Hallelujah. But only what you are going to be asked is only when you receive the call and you accept that call and you accept also to walk according to the will of God, and that you can enter in the service of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So Paul is asking us,
Paul,
we need to offer ourselves. We need to sacrifice ourselves for the kingdom of God. And the kingdom of God is here on earth. And it's also in heaven. Because Jesus is with us here where we are. Hallelujah. The Bible says wherever two people or more than two people will be gathering for my name, I'll be there. Hallelujah. It means we are in the kingdom of God. As we have accepted Jesus to be our personal Savior, and we believe in the word of God, that this word of God is powerful, this word of God came within us to transform our old fashion of living and to start a new fashion of living. Hallelujah. So Paul is saying, let us offer ourselves. Let us sacrifice ourselves. Let us give our time. Let us give our money. Let us give our knowledge that we receive from God for building the kingdom of God. And he continues saying, because it's pleasing to God when we offer ourselves to the Lord, when we sacrifice ourselves for the service, when we accept to serve the Lord, when we accept to offer our bodies, God is happy of that. The Bible says it's pleasing before God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And it continues saying, this is the true and the proper worship. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The proper worship is when you are ready to give yourself for the Lord.
Amen.
And to give yourself for the Lord, it means what is your priority in your life? Do you give God, do you give the Lord the premier position?
Is
your priority? Or you give other things to be the first position? Hallelujah.
Amen.
God should be at the first position.
Mungu lazima kuwe kwa namba moja.
Hallelujah. Because the Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
seek ye first my kingdom.
Tafuta kwanza ufalme wa Mungu.
In my righteousness.
Na haki yangu.
And everything shall be given unto you.
Na ingine yote kufuata.
Hallelujah. To seek first the kingdom of God.
Tafuta kwanza ufalme wa Mungu.
But sometimes we reverse.
Wakati nyingine tunafanya
mambo. This is a powerful statement from the Lord.
Na hiyo ni maneno nguvu kutoka kwa
Bwana. He did not say, seek first other things. But he said, seek first my kingdom. Hallelujah. Because he knew that in his kingdom, everything is there. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Jesus said, seek first my kingdom. And my righteousness. And my justice.
Now, kweli wake,
and other things
na baale, vichu
shall be added unto you.
Ita kuongezeka, Hallelujah. Ita kufuata.
It means if you accept Jesus,
kwa hivyo, kama unakubali Yesu,
and you start seeking for him first,
na unaendelea kumtafuta kwanza,
and accept to be righteous before him,
na unakubali kuwa mwaminifu mbele zake,
you will prosper.
Kwa hivyo, utaendelea kufanikiwa
in Jesus' eyes.
Katika macho ya Bwana.
Hallelujah. We need to be obedient.
Kwa hivyo inabidi tuwe watu watiifu.
And we will see God moving with us.
Tutaona Bwana akitembea
nasi. And for that reason now.
Na kwa hiyo
God is saying.
Paulo anasema.
When you accept to give ourselves.
Wakati unapojitoa.
Church, when my sister you accept to give yourself.
Kaka yangu na mama unapojitoa.
Give yourself in the service.
Ukijitoa katika utumishi
wa Bwana. We have different services in the church.
Tuna kazi tofauti
katika kanisa. We have present worship team.
Kuko nye watu waimbaji.
When you stand and you come here and you sing for the Lord.
Okay, unapokuja hapo na
mwimbia Bwana. It is the service you are offering to the Lord.
Hiyo ni utumishi unamtolea Bwana.
Hallelujah. When you are standing there at the door behind at the back, you are welcoming visitors. God has given you that gift. You are serving the Lord. Hallelujah. When every time you stand and you come here, you are giving people envelopes. You are serving the Lord. The cameraman. When you are doing that, you are doing those shootings. You are serving the Lord. But this has to be constantly. Hallelujah. Not today you are ready. Tomorrow you are not ready. Tomorrow you are ready. After tomorrow you are not ready. Hallelujah. But the Bible is saying here. He says that we need to offer our sacrifice. To offer sacrifice means we need to work hard. Hallelujah. But we are not working hard by ourselves. But through the Holy Spirit. That strengthens us. Paul wants us to have lives which are major to our beliefs. We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe that Jesus Christ did so many miracles. He did so many wonders. We believe in that. But that is not enough.
Na hiyo haitoshi.
Believe.
Kuamini.
Faith.
Iman.
Without action.
Bila matendo.
Faith is dead.
Iman imekufa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Without action.
Bila matendo.
I love Jesus.
Nampenda Yesu.
That is faith. I cannot see it.
Na hiyo ni imani siwezi kuiona.
Hallelujah. Amen. But you need to display it.
Lakini lazima uionyeshe.
Hallelujah. Amen. The love of Christ which is within you.
Ile upendo Yesu Kristo
ndani yako. So that people can come to Christ.
Ili watu wengine wakuje kwa Kristo.
That really this love of Jesus is burning within
Ile
you.
Ile upendo Yesu ndani yanakuchoma ndani yako.
And it goes even outside.
Ili pote kwenda nje.
Toward other people.
Kwa wengine watu.
That it become now action.
Hiyo sasa kwa
your faith you have in Jesus.
Ile imani uko
ndani yako. Is now working outside.
Inatumika nje.
Hallelujah. Amen. So that's why we are saying that there is no really.
Kwa hivyo tunasema hakuna.
Faith without
money bila
without action.
Bila matendo.
Hallelujah. Amen. I've been already justified by Jesus.
Kwa hivyo nimekwisha kubaliwa na Yesu.
What was the time we say that?
Muda mwingine tunasema
hivyo. Jesus died for me.
Yesu alikufa kwa
ajili yangu. I'm justified.
Ni kwa hivyo nimekwisha
kuokolewa. Because of everything he did on the cross.
Kwa yote amefanya msalabani.
That justification
na hiyo tu
is not enough.
Haitoshi.
You need
inabidi
to accompany that.
Inabidi ushindikize hayo
with action.
Na matendo.
With deeds.
Amen.
With act.
Na matendo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So, in the church,
kanisa,
we don't need to be lazy.
Haitubidi tuwe wazaifu.
Hallelujah. Amen. We need to share different gifts that the Lord has given us.
Ni lazima tukawanye karama tofauti.
Surely we don't have all of us the same gifts.
Kwa hivyo kweli sisi wote tuna karama moja.
Hallelujah. But if we want to have a perfect church.
Lakini kama tunataka tuwe na kanisa lenye kuaminika.
A strong church.
Kanisa lenye kuwa na nguvu.
Each gift.
Kila karama
should do its own work.
Lazima ipate kufanya kazi yake.
Hallelujah. When we combine all those gifts,
na tukichanga hizo karama zote,
we are going to see a very special worship here.
Utaona kanisa lenye kuwa tofauti.
Hallelujah. The problem we have in our churches now,
na shida tuko nayo kwa siku ya leo,
there are some people are sitting on their gifts.
Kuko watu ambao wanakalia
karama zao. They have special gifts.
Wako na karama ya muhimu.
But they are saying, why our church is not moving?
Wanasema kwa nini kanisa yetu.
Are you using the gift you have where you are sitting?
Wewe unatumia karama ambayo
uko nayo. Bring your gift.
Leta karama
yako. I combine mine.
Na mimi tayari.
You combine his. All of us we combine our gift.
Yes, sir, tutalipa kwa.
We see changes in this.
Naona kile mabadiliko katika kanisa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I cannot do everything.
Siwezi kufanya chochote.
Hallelujah. I cannot do everything.
Siwezi kufanya kila kitu.
Pastor, I cannot do everything.
Pastor, siwezi kufanya kila kitu.
Brother, Samuel cannot do everything. We need to bring all our gifts we have.
Lazima kila mtu alete karama aliyo nayo.
Hallelujah. And when we do so, in the name of Jesus, I will say, I will tell you, we will see in 1 year that this place is full. Hallelujah. You bring your brick. I bring my stone. You bring your stick. You bring your cement. We put together. That way we build the house.
Hallelujah.
Sometimes we think that, oh, church is for Pastor Mungu. Mungu cannot do everything himself.
Pastor Mungu,
he cannot raise this church himself. He needs other people to support him. He needs Emmanuel to support him. He needs Pastor Mungu to support him. He needs someone to support him. All of us here to support.
And the person who wants to come to
Hallelujah. Amen. Let us leave this way of complaining and accusing other people.
Tuache hii mambo ya kulalamika lalamika na kusema mtu mwingine.
And we have not decided also to enter in the game.
Na tuamua kuingia katika kazi.
Hallelujah. Amen. It's a game.
Kama kazi,
we have to enter in the game of Jesus.
Kama tunaingia katika mchezo wa
Yesu. Hallelujah. Amen. As we know in a soccer team.
Kama tunajua katika kabumbu.
They have 11 players.
Bako na wachezaji.
We have number 1. Number 2 until number 11.
Yeah.
And every number there have its own role. If number 1 is going to slay, they're going to score a goal. If number 2 will slay, they score a goal from number 2.
Yes.
If number 3 will slay, they score a goal. Number 9, if he will not score, they will score to the other side. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we need to work as a team.
Now, kwa hivyo lazima tutumike kama vile.
So I'm encouraging you, as Paul is saying,
ninawahimiza kama kisi Paulo anasema,
let us come together and serve the Lord together.
Ili tukuje pamoja na tufanye kazi pamoja.
That will bring glory to the Lord.
Na hiyo italeta utukufu kwa Bwana.
We serve the Lord.
Kwa hivyo tunatumikia Bwana.
Because
sababu
Jesus served us also.
Sababu Yesu pia atutumikia.
Hallelujah. He accepted.
Alikubali.
He accepted to really to go on the cross.
Alistika kwenda msalabani.
And he died
na kufa
because of my sin.
Kwa ajili ya dhambi
zangu. And because of his sin.
Kwa ajili ya dhambi zake.
You need to learn how to serve.
Naweza kujifunza na mkisha
to serve others.
Ili kutumikia wengine.
Hallelujah. Not to be served.
Sio kujitumikia.
Learn to serve others.
Lakini tujifunze
and God will glorify you.
Na Mungu atakufanya.
Hallelujah. This is what we are talking about here.
Na hiyo ndio tunazungumzia leo
hapa. To unite together.
Tukubali kwa pamoja.
Serve together in the kingdom of God.
Ili tutumike katika falme ya Mungu.
So that we can glorify the kingdom of God.
Ili tupate kuinua utukufu.
To be servants.
Ili tuwatumishi.
Not to be boss.
Bali tusiwe matajiri.
Hallelujah. Amen. Boss people want to be served.
Boss ama watumishi wenye matajiri wanapenda watumikiwe.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. And we can serve in different ways.
Naweza kutumika katika njia tofauti.
First you serve God.
Nalo katika njia kumtumikia Mungu.
And when you serve God,
unapomtumikia Bwana,
you are looking for a relationship with him.
Unakuwa na unatafuta uhusiano na yeye.
Hallelujah. Amen. And that relationship you have with God,
na hiyo uhusiano uko na Mungu,
gives you what with the self confidence,
ndio kukupatia uhakika
of knowing,
ya kujua
that you are a son of God.
Ya kwamba
wewe. Hallelujah. Amen. When you are not serving,
na kati ya mtumikie,
you doubt every day if really you are a Christian.
Na kama mtumikie kila siku unajiuliza kweli mimi ni Mkristo?
Why a Christian?
Je, mimi ni Mkristo?
Am I saved? No, you are saved if you believe in the Lord and you obey His rule already.
Na umeokoka na unatayari na tii sheria.
Hallelujah. You believe already.
Umeamini.
And you are following His commandment.
Na unafuata maamuzi.
You are looking for the relationship with God.
Sasa unatafuta uhusiano na Mungu.
Whenever you have the relationship with God,
wakati unapokuwa na uhusiano na Mungu,
it gives you the self confidence.
Inakupatia uhakika
of saying that you are a son of God.
Ya kwamba wewe ni mwana wa Mungu.
Hallelujah. And when you are a son of God,
and
you are proud in the kingdom, you are not a visitor in the kingdom, but you are fully a servant in the kingdom. Hallelujah. Have you ever seen somebody? When he comes in your house for the first time, he's not going to do everything. He has some reserve.
Atakuwa na muda wa kujitia.
Hallelujah. This is the first time I'm coming in this house.
Ndiye ni mara kwanza
nafika. I don't know the rule of this house.
Sijui sheria
ya how it function.
Sio kisa tumika.
Hallelujah. Amen. So you are a visitor.
Wewe ni mgeni.
But when you are the son of the house.
Lakini kama wewe ni mtoto wa ile nyumba.
You are the king of that house.
Wewe ni mwana wa ile nyumba.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are kings in the kingdom of God.
Kwa sisi na sisi ni wafalme katika ufalme wa Mungu.
Hallelujah. Amen. We are kings there.
Na sisi ni wafalme huko.
We share the king, we share this kingdomship.
Kwa hiyo falme.
So it's for that reason.
Kwa hiyo,
we need to be proud. That God, Jesus has saved us.
Yesu ametuokoa.
And because He saved us,
na kwa sababu ametuokoa,
we can do what?
Nini tunaweza
tukafanya? We can share.
Naweza tukapana.
His love with others.
Upendo wetu, upendo wake kwa watu wengine.
Hallelujah. Amen. You will not share what you don't have.
How to apana ile
kenye. You share what you have. You share what the Lord has given you.
Utapana kila hii Bwana amekupea.
Hallelujah. Amen. But if you are empty,
lakini kama hakuna
kitu, it will be difficult to go.
Itakuwa hanguvu kuenda
and to serve another person.
Na kutumikia watu wengine.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Where to serve the Lord?
Wapi tutumikie
Bwana? We can serve the Lord in many places.
Naweza tukatumikia Bwana katika
yes, we are here, we are serving Him.
Kama jinsi tuko hapa tunamtumikia.
Hallelujah. You can serve the Lord even in the hospital.
Naweza kutumikia Bwana hata kwenye hospitali.
In hospital you can serve the Lord there.
Katika hospitali naweza
kutumikia. In different ways.
Njia tofauti.
People are there.
Watu wako hapo.
They need prayer.
Unahitaji
maombi. You feel that you can pray for him.
Unajisikia kwamba unaweza
kuomba. That is serving the Lord.
Na hiyo ni kufanya kazi ya
Mungu. Hallelujah. Amen. You can serve the Lord by testifying to other people about Christ, what He did for you.
Unaweza kumtumikia Bwana katika kushuhudia wengine.
So we have so many areas where we can serve the Lord.
Kwa hivyo tuko na njia tofauti ya kumtumikia Bwana.
The Bible talks in the book of Matthew.
Biblia inatumia katika kitabu cha Mathayo.
Chapter 6:24.
Mathayo 6 na mstari wa 24. Ndio chakula cha kusomea.
We jump to Romans 12:3-8. You can go to Matthew.
Na ruka Roman 12 na mstari wa 3 hadi 8 tunaenda kwa Mathayo.
Yeah, 6:24.
Ndio maana.
Yeah.
Hakuna mtu awezaye kutumikia mabwana wawili. Maana atachukia mmoja na kupenda huyo wa pili. Au ataambatana na mmoja kumdharau huyo mwingine. Hawezi kumtumikia Mungu na mali pamoja.
Hallelujah. This is what Matthew is talking about.
Usikilize yale Mathayo anazungumzia hapa.
No one can serve two masters.
Hakuna yule anaweza akatumikia Mungu wawili.
Hallelujah. You cannot serve two people.
Hawezi kutumikia watu wawili.
You cannot serve two bosses.
Hawezi kutumikia matajiri wawili.
You cannot serve two masters. And as we know, God is our master. Hallelujah. He's the only one we need to serve first. And the Bible is saying here, you cannot serve two people, two masters. When you serve two masters, you will hate one and love the other one. Hallelujah. So that's what the Bible is saying. Here we need to do what? We need to choose who we are serving in our life. Did we accept to follow Jesus and continue to serve Him? Or we are following Jesus and we want to serve other masters. The Bible is saying us here. So you cannot devote yourself to one master.
Kwa hivyo tuwe tukasema kwa kutitoka kwa mtu mmoja, tukamufalume mmoja.
And devote to another master.
Ama kwa mwingine.
That is no.
Na hiyo,
it means you're going to follow one.
Inabidi fuate mmoja.
And despise another one.
Na uache mwingine.
Now, something which is not true.
Na hiyo sio kweli.
So we need to have one master.
Na tuwe na tajiri mmoja.
And our master is Jesus Christ.
Na tajiri wetu ni
Yesu. Our master is God.
Ni Mungu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know who is your second master in your life.
Sijui wewe nani mwingine.
Maybe in your life your second master.
Labda katika maisha yako boss mwako mwingine.
It is your strength.
Labda ni nguvu zako.
Maybe your master in your life is your money.
Labda mwingine Mungu wako ama boss wako ni.
So you cannot serve the Lord.
Hauwezi kutumikia Mungu.
And want to serve your money.
Na unataka kutumikia pesa zako.
Hallelujah. Amen. Money is something which has been created.
Na pesa ni kitu kiambaye kiliumbiwa.
It has been created by a human being.
Na imeumbwa na mwanadamu.
It's just only a paper.
Ni karatasi.
And people they decide to say that this will call money.
Na watu wakaamua hii itaita pesa.
Hallelujah. Amen. It's just a conversion.
Na hiyo tu ni masikilizano.
Agreement.
Ni masikilizano.
I and Pastor Mondo.
Mimi na mwanadamu.
We say by now.
Nasema leo mimi
na. This is now Kenyan shillings.
Wanasema hii ni my pesa ya Kenya.
Hallelujah. Amen. And people they start using it.
Na watu wanaanza kuitumia.
You go and you buy soda. And you buy everything you want. Hallelujah. So these things have been, it's a paper.
Hiyo ni karatasi.
How do you want to serve the paper?
Na mna kana penda kufanya
kazi. And it is you to create somebody who created the paper.
Na unakataa kuumba ama kukubali yule aliyeumba makaratasi.
Hallelujah. Money is papers.
Kwa hivyo pesa karatasi ama pesa ni makaratasi.
Hallelujah. Amen. So we should not serve money.
Kwa hivyo hatuwezi kutumikia pesa.
Because money was really created.
Kwa hivyo pesa iliumbiwa
by human being.
Na mwanadamu.
So God is above money.
Kwa hivyo Mungu yuko juu ya pesa.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some people when they are in front of money.
Kwa hivyo watu wengine kwa mbele ya pesa.
Oh my God.
Oh,
you will think that is the end of the world.
Watafikiria hiyo ndio mwisho wa dunia.
Hallelujah. Amen. But we need to know.
Walakini inabidi tu
that money should not take really our time.
Kwa hivyo pesa sichukue muda wetu.
Even though money help us to survive, help us to buy things.
Hata kama pesa tusaidia kununua vitu.
But money cannot take the position of the creator.
Kwa hivyo pesa haiwezi kukamata nafasi ya Mungu.
So we are saying we should not have two masters.
Ndiyo mwa tunasema atubili tuwa na wa boss wa wili.
But we have only one master.
Bali tuko na umoja tu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your second master can be your work, your job.
Kwa hivyo, wa boss wa second master, boss wa kwa pili, boss wa kwa ni kazi wa mtu ingine.
Hallelujah. But we need to understand all these things.
Lakini tunapaswa kuelewa hii yote.
Cannot be compared.
Haiwezi kupimanishwa.
By God who is our creator.
Na Mungu aliyetuumba.
So we cannot serve two masters, we need to have one master, and if God is our creator who created the universe and who created also the heaven.
Kwa hivyo lazima tupate kumwabudu na kumsifu Mungu aliyeumba mbingu na dunia.
So sometimes we need to choose in our life.
Kwa hivyo lazima tuchague katika maisha yetu.
Hallelujah. Amen. We need to choose in our life.
Lazima tuchague katika maisha yetu.
The Bible says,
Biblia inatuambia,
if you are not called,
kama si uko bali,
or if you are not hot,
kama uko bali na uko
moto, I'm going to vomit you.
Atenda kuatapia.
You need to show where you are standing.
Yes. Lazima upate kuonyesha
mahali. Show your position.
Onyesha
msimamo wako. Tangaza msimamo wako.
Tangaza mwenyewe mahali.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We need to show who you are.
Lazima utangaze wewe ni nani.
Some people when they are somewhere,
wana watu wengine wakiwa first floor.
They don't want to be recognized as they are Christian.
Hawataki wajulikane kama ni wa Kristo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They are Christian only when they are here in the church.
Yeah. Wako wa Kristo tu wakiwa kanisani.
Show your identity wherever you are.
Wonyesha
Kristo wako mahali popote ulipo. Hallelujah. Show your identity where you are.
Wonyesha Kristo wako mahali popote ulipo.
Hallelujah. People of this world,
what are we doing?
They want to identify themselves wherever they are.
Watu wanataka kujionyesha wenyewe ugizi walivyo.
Hallelujah. So show your identity where you are. If you are a Christian, you are a Christian.
Na wewe wajionyeshe kama uko mkristo, uko mkristo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
People are talking about nonsense.
Na watu wanasema mambo haina maana.
Can you bring something, a word of of Jesus even also to come and intervene in that discussion.
Wakati tena watu kwa naongea vitu neno maana unaleta na wewe ile neno la Mungu katikati yao.
To show that we have different view of the world.
Ili tupate kuonesha kama tuko wengine mambo katika ulimwengu.
We have different view of the world.
Na lazima tuoneshe kama tuko wengine hali ya kuona katika ulimwengu.
Hallelujah. Some people they believe that this world was created only that this it came itself.
Na wengine wafikiria kwamba hii dunia kuumbiwa lakini ilikuja binafsi.
But we will believe that there was a creation.
Lakini sisi tunaamini kwamba kuna yule aliyeumba.
There is a beginning of everything.
Na tunajua kwamba kila kitu kina mwanzo.
Hallelujah. Amen. If there is a beginning of everything,
na kama kuko kila kitu kina mwanzo,
it means there is a creator of that everything.
Kwa hivyo tunajua kwamba kuna muumbaji.
Hallelujah. Amen. So we need to show that is a way of serving the Lord. Wherever you are, you can display who you are.
Kwa hivyo lazima upate kujua kwamba uonyeshe identity yako ili mahali pote kwenda wajue wewe ni nani.
We should not hide ourselves.
Hatubidi tujifiche.
Oh, you know, if I show that I'm a Christian,
nikiosha kama mimi nimeokoka,
people they gonna laugh at me.
Watanichekea.
If you are thinking like that,
unapofikiria vile,
even in heaven,
hata mbinguni,
Jesus will continue laughing at you.
Na Bwana atatenda.
Hallelujah. Jesus wants people who are courageous.
Na Mungu anapenda watu wenye kuwa na bidii.
Hallelujah. You are ready to say who you are, no matter.
Wako tayari kusema wewe ni nani.
Hallelujah. If you are a Christian, you are a Christian.
Kama wewe ni Mkristo,
if you are not a Christian, you are not a Christian.
Na kama sio Mkristo, sio Mkristo.
Hallelujah. That is what Jesus wants.
Hiyo ndio Yesu
anayokuwa. You go to a party.
Ukienda kwenye fete.
You don't want to show that. You don't want to disclose yourself.
Na unapenda kujulikana mwenyewe.
Yeah, even you are in a party.
Hata kama uko katika sherehe.
Yeah, there are things you can say.
Kuna vitu unaweza kusema.
There are things you cannot say.
If
you are a Christian,
kama wewe ndio.
Hallelujah. Amen. Don't move with the group.
Usiende na kikundi.
Don't move with people.
Usiende na watu.
Move with the heart of the Lord.
Lakini enda na roho yake.
Hallelujah. What the Lord is telling you to say.
Kini roho anakuambia useme.
We will know them by their deeds, we know them by their actions.
Tutajua kwa matendo yao.
People who are called Christians,
wale wanaitwa Wakristo,
not because of their talking,
sio juu kisa unavyosema,
but because of what you are doing.
Bali
there is somebody. There is somebody to Jesus.
Wanafananishwa na Yesu.
There is somebody to Christ.
Wanafanana na Kristo.
Let us call them Christians.
Acha waitwe Wakristo.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we need to move like that.
Naweza tutembee hivyo.
If we read the book of Joshua,
tukisoma katika kitabu cha Joshua
24:15.
23:24 na mstari wa Waka 15.
Read for us that place, Pastor, the Sabbath of God, Charles. Joshua.
Lakini, kama vile Mwenyezi Mungu, Mungu wenu, alivyotimiza mambo yote, mema aliyoyaahidi, hivyo hivyo, anaweza kuwaletea maovu yote, mpaka awaangamize yote. Kutoka nchi hii nzuri ambayo amewapenda.
That is it, Joshua 15?
15.
24:15, Joshua.
Okay. Joshua. Okay. Kama hamtaki kumtumikia Mwenyezi Mungu, basi chagueni leo hii ni nani mtakaye mtumikia, kwamba ni miungu ile ambayo wazee wenu walimtumikia ngambo ya mto Efrati, au miungu ya Waamori ambao sasa unaishi nchini mwao. Lakini mimi na nyumba yangu tutamtumikia Mwenyezi Mungu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is Joshua.
Who
is
Joshua?
The children of Israel.
Wana wa
Israel. Up and down, up and down, up and down in their conduct.
Watoto wa Israel walikuwa kienda juu chini juu chini.
They were following so many evil things.
Walikuwa kifuata mambo mabaya.
They were adoring other gods.
Walikuwa kiabudu mambo
mingi. Instead of adoring and obey and also worship the true God.
Walikuwa kuabudu Mungu wa kweli.
Joshua here is speaking.
Na Joshua hapa anasema.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You need to choose.
That's what to
who you gonna serve.
Nani uchague, nani utakayemtumikia.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
For the children of Israel, serving the Lord was becoming like a burden for them.
Watoto wazaliwa kutumikia Mungu ilikuwa kama vile ni shida kwao.
And something when it becomes like a burden for you.
Na kama kitu inakuwa sawa vile baria.
It means it becomes very very difficult to carry.
Kwa hivyo inakuwa vitu vikubwa kubeba.
Now Joshua is asking them.
Hapa Joshua.
If the burden now is very heavy.
Na kama mzigo imekuwa mzito.
You need to choose.
Lazima uchague.
Hallelujah. If you continue to carry this burden,
na kama unataka kubeba hii mzigo,
or if you are ready to drop it down,
ama uko tayari kuiacha.
Hallelujah. We need to declare, we need to show what we believe.
Lazima tuseme nini tunayoamini.
Who we are ready to serve?
Nani ambaye tuko tayari?
Are we to serve the God who delivered from Egypt?
Je, tuko tayari kumtumikia Mungu aliyetoa?
Are we ready to serve the God who helped in the desert?
Ambaye ametuokoa katika jangwa.
Are we ready to serve the God who promised us the promised land?
Je, tuko tayari kutumikia Mungu ambaye ametuahidia udongo utakatifu?
Oh, we want to go back where we came from.
Ama mnataka turudi mahali tumetoka.
Hallelujah. Amen. God prepared many many servants the Lord.
Kwa hivyo Bwana ameandaa mambo mengi.
He prepared Joseph in Egypt to serve his own people.
Aliandaa Yoshua katika Misri kwa kutumikia watu wa
Joseph. He prepared Joseph.
Aliprepare Yusufu kutumikia wana wa Israeli.
He prepared also Moses to deliver the children of Israel to go to the promised land.
Na kamuandaa Musa kuwatoa Misri ili kuwapeleka katika mahali maandalizi.
Hallelujah. Today God also is preparing you here in Canada.
Kwa hivyo leo Mungu anakuandaa hapa Canada.
So that you can serve as a people.
Ili upate kutumikia watu wengine.
Hallelujah. Same way he used Joseph.
Ile vile vile vio
the same way he used Joshua.
Kisa alitumikisha Yoshua.
The same way he used Jesus.
Vile vile alivyomtumikisha Yesu.
He is here.
Yuko hapa.
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 To use you and I.
Ili apate kutumikia wewe na
mimi. Hallelujah. It is the same spirit.
Ni ile roho moja.
The spirit of the Lord is not divided. It's the same spirit that is still working up today. The same spirit
he
put in Joseph. He will put it in you. The same spirit he put in Joshua. He will put it in you. Joshua is saying, if you are not ready to serve my God, my house, myself, we will serve the Lord. We will serve the Lord. Are you ready to serve the Lord? Are you ready to serve the Lord? You
are
in your house. Are you ready to serve the Lord?
God
was saying, my house and me, we will serve the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We will serve the Lord. This will be our declaration.
From
our problem.
No matter summertime. Hajua katikani.
We gonna serve the Lord.
Tenda kumtumikia Mungu.
Hallelujah. He said you need to choose.
Lazima kuchagua.
You need to choose.
Lazima kuchagua.
If the burden is heavy.
Kama mzigo ni mzito.
Drop it down.
Shusha chini.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But if you are going to still to carry it.
Na kama unataka kuipeleka.
God will lift you.
Mungu
anakuinua. He said like this.
Anasema,
come to me.
Kuja kwangu.
With all your burden. I will give you rest. Hallelujah. No matter problem you have.
If
you are saying that I don't serve the Lord. Because I have this problem. This problem is not for you. It's not for you. Bring to the Lord. He says this problem is mine. He will take it. He will take it. And say, this problem is not you. Pastor Moses Mode, you know. This problem is not
yours.
You are struggling with it. Bring it to me. And I'm going to give you rest. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So sometimes we struggle. We think that this work belongs to us. This work is not for us. The works belong to the Lord. Hallelujah. He is the master of the harvest. Hallelujah. He is the master of the harvest. Accept only to obey. And continue to follow his path. To accept to serve him. And he will lift you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Church, City Church.
Kanisa.
We need to accept to serve the Lord. We need to stand where we are. We need to stand where we are sitting on our seats. And start serving the Lord. Let us use different talent we have. Hallelujah. The Lord has given a different talent. Let us use those talents now. Let us say for now. For now.
Leo.
For now and ever.
Leo.
I will start serving the Lord. We need to declare that in the church.
Let us say
the church does not belong to me.
Can you say
the church does not belong to you?
See Yahoo.
The church does not belong to him.
See Yahoo.
The church belongs to all of us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We need to stand on our feet.
Let us show them
the way to serve the Lord.
You need to become one.
You will see change in this
church.
Hallelujah. Sing that when they stand.
Come on, imagine
a show. With soft voices,
we feel
that the Spirit of God is moving. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why?
Why?
Because they can use their gifts.
Hallelujah.
Amen. If you are a musician, you play very nicely the keyboard. How many play for us the keyboard there?
Sit here.
And the angel will come and worship with us.
Hallelujah.
This is what we need here. My sister, my brother, in the beginning we say, Paul is saying, I am the one urging you also. My brothers and my sisters. Because I can see here I have my sisters. I have my brothers. The Lord wants you. The Lord wants you. Come to him and serve him. And he will lift you up. Hallelujah. Let us unite together in the service. Hallelujah. If you're going to join the mama's department, join it. If you're going to join the youth, you have a talent to use there. Come.
Come on, Jenny, Vijana.
If you want to do something in the choir, come and do it.
Come on, perform with choir, kuja.
If you are a preacher, come and preach the gospel.
Come on, mubiri, kuja, mubiri.
Hallelujah. Amen. That will change the atmosphere.
Na hapo the man shahidi.
Holiness will come.
Na utukufuta.
Glory will come.
Na utukufuta.
Because everything is at its place.
Na masaa kila kitu kwa nafasi.
Hallelujah. Amen. If everything will be at its place.
Na kama kila kitu kwa nafasi.
This will move smoothly.
Na tena kila kitu.
Everything will be okay. There will be no struggling because we are not here to work by ourselves, but we are calling the help from God to come and help us in whatever we are doing. My house and me, who is of the Lord, says
Joshua.
Hallelujah. This should be the statement coming from our mouth. Myself and my house.
Mimi na nyumba yangu.
Who will serve City
Church?
It is our house.
Ni nyumba yetu.
It's the kingdom of the Lord.
Hiyo ni kwa
ufalme. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Nothing is impossible with God.
Hakuna
kisiwezekana move by love.
Tukienda kwa
mtu. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To summarize it, to conclude.
Kwa kumalizia,
we are talking about to serve the Lord.
Tuko tukisema kutumikia Bwana.
And we say that we need to give ourselves.
Na nasa tunaweza
tujitoe. By giving ourselves.
Tunapotoa wenyewe.
We see that it's not our power we are using.
Kwa hivyo tena kwa maana
but it's the Lord using us.
Kwa hiyo kwa vipi
tunapotoa Bwana? We can serve the Lord where?
Wapi tunaweza?
We can serve the Lord in the church.
Kanisani.
We can serve the Lord even in a school.
Hata kwa masomo.
We can serve the Lord even in the hospital.
Hata kwa masomo.
We can serve the Lord in our community.
Mahali popote.
We can serve the Lord even in the government.
Hata katika gouvernement.
Hallelujah. Even the government, you can serve the Lord there.
Hata katika government tunaweza kutumikia Bwana hapo.
Hallelujah. And finally we said, as children of God, we need to choose. Hallelujah. If we are hot, we are hot. We should not be hot and cold. Hallelujah. If we are cold and hot, we are going to be vomited.
We're
going to be vomited by God. Hallelujah. But Joshua says, my household, hallelujah, and myself, we are going to serve the Lord. Hallelujah. Matthew 28:19-20 says,
Matthew,
it's not written there, The Bible says we should go to preach the gospel all over the world, so that whoever will believe, hallelujah, shall be saved. Hallelujah. And he will enter in the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Let us be servants, and God will be glorified. In the name of the Lord. Amen.
Amen. Please, can you give a big hand?
Amen.
This is a powerful message of the man of God. Thank you. Just give us that.